All right. Number one, the instructions say to clearly show the method used and the steps involved in arriving at your answers. Now, that's exactly the wording that you're going to see on the AP exam. So get used to that. In other words, it's my way of saying show all work, show all steps, show all units. Yeah. All right, so number one, hexanoic acid, and the formula's there, is a monoprotic acid. What's monoprotic?
100.
Dissociates, very good. And an aqueous solution is represented in the equation above. The equilibrium concentration for the hexanate ions is equal to 0.00332 molarity. And when is that? Is that initial? Oh, at equilibrium. Very good. Yes. Notice these key words. Hexanoic's initial concentration is 0.75 molar at 298. And then again, assume that the temperature remains the same, even though there's no part D on there. All right, so part A says write the expression for the acid dissociation constant Ka for the hexanoic acid, and then calculate its value. And I'll tell you, don't use 5% rule. Because I said so.
AP Chem go hard.
It doesn't say not to use the 5% rule.
Oh, but it does. You're just not reading between the lines.
Where in the world is that?
Where in the world?
AP Chem go hard.
All right, so we've got our formula here, the makings of our ice chart. Do we know our initial concentration of the hexanoic acid?
Yep.
What is it?
Don't we just have to write the
0.75.
Is
that a plus or minus on the C6?
Negative 1. Okay. Do we know the initial concentration of hydrogen or the hexanate?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a zero.
Yep.
Okay. What are we told about either hydrogen, hexanate, or hexanoic acid?
Hexanate,
the equilibrium is 0.00332.
Wow. 0.00332?
Yeah. So what does that say about 5%?
X equals.
That's equal to X. Very good. So we know what X is. That in this cool.
Yeah, I told you it can go hard.
So then we can write the expression, which it asks us to do. They're very special. Leave them alone. Perfect. So now we have our values. So point, and again, this is a past AP exam question. Oh yeah, I think I'm good enough to come up for these problems.
Yeah.
Go on to collegeboard.com.
Can we get them?
Oh yeah. So if you want to be like the cool kids and get them, you can.
Where do you get those little books?
These? Amazon.
Or is that the best one?
I like five steps.
So if somebody watched this video, would they just think you're talking to yourself?
Pretty much.
Why do we always run out of room?
So they're not going to hear me say, if you can't go home.
Nope.
Why not?
So, we have 1.48 times 10 to the negative, what is that, 5?
5.
How can you not read? You have
your glasses on. Every time you're like, who's that? Mr. Craig, that
makes you laugh.
No. Part B. That's part A. Calculate the pH of this solution. How are we going to be able to do that?
Take the anti-log.
Ooh, I hope
no.
Not.
No,
I'm still on it.
No, you're not.
I am.
You're looking at it.
You're conceding it.
There you go.
There you go. Take it to your head.
How can I find the pH?
Take the negative log.
Of this?
Yeah.
Did you say that?
My bad. I'm not saying anti, my fault.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
My bad, people in the video.
That's right, they're going to think, oh, Avon's a very special school. We know.
Are you talking to me? We're on B.
2.4.
We're on B.
2.4.
B.
2.48. Yeah, we on B, folks.
2.48.
How about 2.48?
Oh, I think that sounds great.
You're welcome.
2.48.
Okay. So let me put that up here. No, we're ready for C. It's not that I didn't put anything on the back. It's.
So this is new?
No. All right, part C. Actually, let me hear. Everybody got this? I'm going to zap this. Actually, slide it. Sorry, Nicole. All right, part C says calculate the pH of a solution formed by dissolving 21.7 grams of the solid cesium hexanate, which the formula is given there, in 250 milliliters of our 0.75 molar hexanoic acid. Assume that the volume change is negligible. This time, I gave you a little note there, this time we will write the ice chart in a way that expresses the addition of a solid and causes the reaction to shift to the right. I think that's what we've been doing. Okay. All right, so cesium hexanate is O2. And what is cesium hexanate? So what? What is cesium hexanate? It's a salt. Good. So it dissociates completely. Because we have a conjugate of a what here?
Base.
Good. Strong base. Ooh, it's a plus one.
Wait, how do you know that?
Because I have my strong acids and bases memorized, or I have my periodic table in front of me.
Okay, I got it. Oh, we have to know those?
Yes. And we have a common ion from the last part. Okay. So the cesium will not do anything, and we'll start off with our hexanate. So if this is a common ion of this, this is acting like a what? Or what is this? That's an acid, very good, since it is hexanoic acid. And this is our common ion, which behaves as a, therefore,
that's a base.
This is acting like a base. So what will it do to water?
It'll give it to the C6H4.
So we're going to rip a hydrogen off of that, and we'll form our hexanoic acid, which is a weak acid, and more importantly, hydroxide. It says that we have 21.7 grams of the solid cesium hexanate. We probably want to find out the molarity for this. So we'll go 21.7 grams, convert that to moles, and cesium I don't have memorized.
Why not?
132.91. Plus six carbons.
Me too.
Plus 11 times 1.008. Plus 2 times 16.
No.
248.058, right? Grams. And what is my total volume that this is placed in? 250 milliliters. Okay, or 0.25 liters. So if you want to do it this way, just to be fancy, you may. So my milliliters cancel, my grams cancel. I'm left with moles per liter. Sweet. Let's get a number for that. 0.350. How's that? Does anybody agree with that?
I know, Mr. Craig.
I agree.
Mr. Craig, okay. I agree.
So 0.350. What's my value for the water?
Zero. I mean the dash.
Dash. Very good. What do I do for the hexanate?
You put a zero next to it.
Put a zero next to it?
No, 0.75.
0.75? Good. So that's what it says in the question. And hydroxide? Approximately zero. Very good. So we are adding a salt to our system at equilibrium, which we just calculated pH 4, which was 2.48. Okay. Remember your little beaker here? Then we place that salt in there.
Why do you draw that every time?
You like that? Okay. So the pH originally was 2.48. We're trying to find out what the pH of this is now, after we place that salt in there. All right, so we'll subtract X, add X, find the hydroxide. Wow, what is that? All right, now, can we use the Ka value here? We need to find a KB because we have hydroxide, right? So let's calculate our KB, KW over KA, which is 10 to the negative 14. And what was our KA again? 1.48. Good. And that equals... What'd you guys get? Did you guys get 9.73? You did? That's wrong.
I knew that was bad, so I didn't say anything.
All right, so there's our KB. So once we have our KB, let's write our expression that goes along with that. And OH so now we can plug in our values. So 0.75 plus X. Did you guys want to use 5%?
Yeah.
Wait, can we?
Can you?
Yeah.
I think I'll allow you. If it's alright with everybody else.
What are you doing here?
Okay. So, and that's all equal to our KB. So hydroxide. And we're going to move that up, multiply that, divide that. And 0.350. So nothing new, right?
Why have you started putting OH per X?
I think you said we closed it. So we are using it.
You didn't do that last time.
Why, I did. But that's all right.
Dondre just asked if we're using the 10%.
What happened?
Nothing.
So the hydroxide's that? Is it possible to find pH?
Yes.
How would I do that, Dondre?
14 minus.
Calling you out, man. In front of the nation.
14 minus.
14 minus that?
The negative log of that. Right.
I don't know. I'm asking you.
I said it.
14 minus the negative log of the hydroxide?
The 3.15 times 10 to the yes.
Yep.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Nuts.
All right.
Aw, yeah. Try to scare me. That's righteous credit.
Never be afraid if you're right.
Percent
4.50?
Yeah.
That's right.
That is right.
I didn't say anything this time.
50.
All right, now, let's ask a great question.
Okay. You're on the screen again.
It's all right. They can hear me. That's more important. When we did our solution, we found out that the pH for our acidic solution back here for the hexanoic acid was 2.48. And then we added this salt, which acted like a base, right?
Yeah.
And it caused the pH to go up. Does that seem right?
Yes.
Good. Okay. More basic. Yeah, so it should make the pH more basic, which means that we should elevate the pH. All right.